हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर श्रुति गुप्ता, मेडिकल डायरेक्टर एट स्किनोस हेयर एंड स्किन क्लिनिक दिल्ली। डार्क स्पॉट्स और डार्क पैचेस, आल्सो नोन एज हाइपर पिगमेंटेशन, इज अ वेरी कॉमन कंडीशन फेस्ड बाय पीपल। व्हाट इज दिस हाइपर पिगमेंटेशन? हाइपर पिगमेंटेशन सिंपली मीन्स दैट द अफेक्टेड एरिया इज डार्कर देन द सराउंडिंग स्किन। इट अकर्स व्हेन द पिगमेंट प्रोड्यूसिंग सेल्स प्रोड्यूस पिगमेंट मोर देन द नॉर्मल। दिस पिगमेंट इज मेलानिन। It is the same pigment which gives black color to our hair. When this melanin is produced in excess in the skin, this results in hyperpigmentation. So, hyperpigmentation is a broad term. It can occur because of various reasons. The most common reason causing hyperpigmentation is following any inflammation in the skin. The inflammation may occur because of acne, or because of any injury or trauma to the skin, or because of sunburn. In this case, it is known as post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. The other reasons of pigmentation include melasma, sunspots, age spots, freckles, lentigens, and other medical conditions like acanthosis nigricans. In this video, today, I will be discussing in detail about melasma. Melasma is a chronic skin condition seen as dark brown or gray patches on the face. It usually affects the cheeks, the bridge of the nose, the forehead, upper lips, and sometimes also the jawline area. It usually occurs between the age group of 20 to 40 years and occurs in both males and females. Considering its distribution, melasma can cause a lot of stress, anxiety, and decreased self-confidence, and can impair one's social and personal life. Melasma occurs because of multiple factors. The most important factor causing melasma is chronic sun exposure. Long-term sun exposure to harmful rays, either because of outdoor activities or improper sun protection, leads to stimulation of the pigment-producing cells to produce more pigment, which gets deposited in the skin, thus resulting in melasma. Another important factor causing melasma is hormone changes. So, hormonal changes due to pregnancy or taking oral contraceptive pills or hormone replacement therapy can aggravate melasma. In fact, melasma is so common in females during pregnancy that it has been given a separate term known as cloasma or mask of pregnancy. The other common risk factors causing melasma include stress, excessive heat exposure, and excessive use of cosmetics and other scented products. Melasma has also been associated with a strong genetic predisposition. One in every three cases report a positive family history. Because melasma is a chronic condition, it requires a long-term treatment. Melasma is treated in two phases. You have the initial phase to reduce the pigmentation and then the maintenance phase to keep away the pigmentation. The most important pillar for treatment of melasma is proper sun protection. If you are using all the depigmenting products in the world but not taking sun protection, then do not expect your melasma to fade away. So sun protection is the most important step. So use a sunscreen, preferably a physical sunscreen containing zinc oxide and titanium dioxide with a sun protection factor of 30 or more. The benefits of using a physical sunscreen is that it is a broad spectrum sunscreen. It will give protection against UVA rays, UVB rays, as well as the visible rays. So sunscreen should be applied daily, 365 days in a year, and even if you are not going outside and staying indoors. And it should be applied 15 minutes before stepping out and then reapplied every 2 hours. Additionally, according to the latest research, it has been shown that even the infrared rays tend to aggravate melasma by causing oxidation of the skin cells. So adding an antioxidant to your morning regimen is a good option. And the best antioxidant that can be used is vitamin C in the form of a serum. And we can apply this vitamin C serum before the sunscreen in the morning. So vitamin C will not only protect against the oxidative damage of the skin, but in addition to that, it also helps in reducing the pigmentation because it decreases the activity of the pigment cells. Additionally, do not forget that whenever you are going out under the sun, carry an umbrella or cover your face with a scarf or a hat for extra sun protection. The next important part of the management of melasma is use of depigmenting agents. The gold standard depigmenting agent is hydroquinone. It is the strongest depigmenting agent and is prescribed for nighttime usage during the initial phases. Once we attain the desired results, we substitute the hydroquinone with other milder depigmenting products which contain azelaic acid or kojic acid or glycolic acid or arbutin during the maintenance phase. Another relatively newer but very effective modality of treatment is tranexamic acid. Adding oral tranexamic acid to the existing treatment option boosts the results, and tranexamic acid has become very popular among dermatologists worldwide for the management of melasma. So that's all about the oral and the topical treatment modalities. Let me also discuss some of the procedural treatments which are available to treat melasma. These includes chemical peel, microneedling with PRP, also famously known as vampire facial, and lasers. Now, chemical peels is a procedure in which certain products are applied on the skin to cause controlled exfoliation of the skin and cause a depigmenting effect. The most common type of chemical peels used for treatment of melasma are glycolic acid, trichloroacetic acid, and Jesner's peel. Usually, a series of 4 to 6 sessions of chemical peels is sufficient to give good results. Microneedling with PRP is one of the most effective treatment for melasma. Here what we do is, we first withdraw a small amount of your blood sample, which is processed in a machine. This separates plasma from the blood, and the plasma will be rich in platelets. That is why it is called platelet-rich plasma or PRP. And this PRP has lots of growth factors. Then we create tiny micro injuries on the skin using a handheld instrument, and then the PRP is massaged onto the skin. This stimulates all the cells present in the skin to divide and rejuvenate, resulting in clearing of the pigmentation. In addition, it also brings about improvement in the fine lines and wrinkles and cause a skin tightening effect. The use of lasers in treatment of melasma is controversial. Why? Because the heat energy produced during the laser treatment can stimulate the pigment cells, thus worsening your pigmentation. Hence, lasers is not our first choice of treatment for treating melasma. Because melasma is associated with multiple factors, it is always a combination of treatments that gives the best results. This should include a good morning regimen with vitamin C and sunscreen, a night regimen using depigmenting agents, oral tranexamic acid, and 4 to 6 sessions of either chemical peel or vampire facial. Once you have achieved your desired results, do not forget that melasma has a tendency to come back again and again. So follow a judicious maintenance regimen regularly.